everyone. So today I'm going to have a additional problem on beam column. So, but this time we will be considering the moment amplification factor. Okay, what is this moment amplification method? Okay, the moment amplification method entails computing the maximum bending moment resulting from flexural loading, transverse loads or member and moments. By a first order analysis, then multiplying by a moment amplification factor to account for the secondary moment. Amplification factor is a multiplier used to increase the computed moment in a member to account the eccentricity of the load and is given by the following equation. So as you can see from this figure on the right side, so figure A and figure B. Okay, yung figure A, this is an example of a beam column, which is basically the ends or the joints are in place. So meaning to say that on figure A, the beam column doesn't experience any side sway. Okay? So pagka hindi siya nagsa-side sway, then due to the compressive force P, so the member tends to buckle like this. Okay? So pagka nagbabuckle yung member natin dyan, if you cut the section somewhere at the mid height, okay, so then you draw the free body diagram or the forces acting on the cut section, you will notice that the force acting here, diba? So let's say for this case, so when you cut this section over here, so that would be in equilibrium, so that would be another P. Equilibrium with this capital P, no? Pero because of that small delta, this is small delta, so you will have the P small delta effect. And that P small delta effect actually is a moment, diba? So it is actually a couple. Couple is a moment. So ibig sabihin, when you have a beam column being analyzed without side sway, and due to its buckling, there is an introduction of additional moment due to that P delta effect. Okay? So, ibig sabihin, when we analyze beam column with such a case, we have to amplify the moment experienced by the beam column due to that P delta effect. Okay? So, likewise, yung sa figure letter B naman, as you can see, okay, so figure letter B. This is the case naman kapag you have the beam column wherein the upper joint translates. Ibig sabihin, mayroong side sway. Okay, so yung big delta doon, yung big delta, this is big delta, that is the displacement of the joint due to side sway. So again, kapag nag-translate yung joint at the top, okay, due to that force P, there will be also a P capital delta effect na tinatawag. So for this case, it's P capital delta effect. And that P capital delta effect is actually a moment also, diba? That is also a couple that would be contributed to the additional moment experienced by the beam column. Okay, so due to this P delta effects, okay, so we have to consider that by amplifying the moment experienced by the beam column. So how do we amplify those moments? This is through this variable B sub 1. Okay, B sub 1 and actually B sub 2. Okay, yung B sub 1, this is the amplification factor, this one. B sub 1 is the amplification factor for moments occurring in the member when it is braced against side sway, meaning walang side sway tayo. And this is to consider the P small delta effect. While yung B sub 2 in this equation, okay, that is the amplification factor for the moments resulting from side sway naman. If the beam column experiences side sway, and that is due to the P capital delta moment effects. Okay? So again, yung B1, kapag ka walang side sway, yung B2, kapag ka may side sway. Okay, now, so from the equation as per code provision, B sub 1 should be greater than 1. Kasi nga, amplification is, so it tends to amplify. Pinapalaki niya yung moment due to that P delta effect. So in computing for B1, that would be Cm divided by 1 minus Pu over P. So with this equation. Again, the B1 calculated should be always greater than or equal to 1. In cases wherein you calculated B1 to be less than 1, so you just use B1 equals 1, the limit. Okay, so that would be the limit for B sub 1. Now, ano yung CM? Okay, yung PU, as we know, is the factored axial load. Okay, so that is the factored axial load. Tapos yung PE, that is the Euler's load given by this equation. Okay, so basically, ang bago rito yung CM. Now, what is CM? Okay, then after you have calculated for that B1, so yung bagong MU natin would become MU is equal to B1 times MNT plus B2 MLT. Okay, yung MNT is this one. That is the factored load moment assuming that there's no side sway occurring. Okay, so isipin nung NT dyan is no translation, walang side sway. Tapos yung B2MLT naman, yung MLT naman, that is the factored load moment. Okay, factored load moment caused by side sway naman, pagka may side sway. So if we analyze a beam column ng walang side sway, so basically ang mangyayari sa atin is MU is just equal to B1 times MN, no translation. Ito yung without side sway. Okay? So, B1 times the MNT or the moment with no translation. Okay, so yung previous example natin, yung sample problem 1 natin, we didn't consider moment amplification factor dun. Okay, so ibig sabihin, yung MU na ginamit natin dun is just the MN with no translation. So, on this example, on this topic, we will be considering the moment amplification factor to be used in solving for the MU. Okay, ano yung CM? CM is called as the moment correction factor or sometimes it is also called as reduction coefficient. Okay, so we have three cases on CM values. Okay, yung case one, yung CM natin is 0.85. This is applicable kapag kayong beam column is part of a frame or part of an unbraced frame. When I say unbraced frame, meaning it experiences side sway. So may side sway dyan. So again, kapag kayong beam column is part of a frame wherein the frame experiences side sway, okay, the CM na i-apply mo for that beam column would be 0.85. Okay, so that is for unbraced frame or frame experiencing side sway. Okay, yung case 2, this is applicable naman for restrained compression members in frames braced against joint translation and not subjected to transverse loading. Ibig sabihin, without side sway naman tayo dito. So as you can see from the figure, the frame is braced. Okay? So because of the presence of the cross bracing, diba? So even though may lateral load na naka-apply dun sa joint B, hindi pa rin siya mag-experience ng side sway because of that cross bracing provided. Okay, so again, yung case 2 is applicable kapag yung beam column is part of a brace frame. At the same time, second condition, yung beam column natin doesn't have any transverse load on its span. Walang transverse load. Okay? So, paano makukuha yung CM for that case? Siyempre, since brace yung frame, walang side sway, so basically, it would be, may mga joint moments tayo makukompute dun sa mga joints ng bawat frame natin. Okay? So, may mga end moments tayo makukompute. So, the CM can be calculated by this equation as 0.6 minus 0.4 of M1 over M2. Again, yung M1 tsaka M2, these are the end moments on the beam column. Wherein M1 is the smaller end moment. Tapos yung M2 would be the larger end moments. Okay? Tapos, so basically, yung M1 over M2 is always less than 1 kasi smaller divided by larger end moments. Tapos, you have to affix the sign. No? May sign convention tayo dun sa ratio ng M1 tsaka M2. We have to affix negative sign. Okay? Negative yung M1 over M2 kapag ka single curvature. This is single curvature. It creates a single curvature on the beam. So, that would be possible kapag ka opposing direction. Diba ito, clockwise, ito counterclockwise. So, diba? So, it produces a single curvature on the member. Okay, so pagka single curvature or opposing direction of end moments, negative yung M1 over M2 natin. Tapos yung positive naman siya, positive naman yung ratio ng M1 tsaka M2 naman kapag ka may reverse. Reversed curvature. Ibig sabihin, it's either nakaganyan. Okay, so reverse. So, ibig sabihin yung end moments have the same direction. Ito, clockwise, ito rin clockwise. So again, kapag ka the same direction of end moments, let's say pareha silang clockwise or pareha silang counterclockwise, the same direction, positive yung M1 over M2 natin. Because it produces a reversed curvature. Okay? So, yan yung value ng CM kapag ka sa case 2, without side sway, at saka with no transverse load. Transverse loads. So, yan yung condition for case 2. Now, for case 3 naman, this is applicable for compression members in frames, brace against joint translation. So, meaning, without side sway uli. Okay, walang side sway, but in this case, meron siyang transverse load with transverse load. Again, transverse loads, these are the loads perpendicular to the axis of the member. So assuming from this figure for this given frame, these are transverse loads. So these are transverse loads. Transverse loads. Okay, so for that case, the CM may be dalawa. CM would be 0.85 kapag yung ends ng beam column natin are restrained, meaning both ends fixed. Okay, so both ends fixed. So, ano ba? Ganyan. So, fixed sa taas, fixed sa baba. Okay, so 0.85. Ito naman yung one. This is kapag unrestrained naman yung ends ng beam column natin. Basically, it's a hinge. Both ends hinge or pins. CM is equal to 1.0. Okay? So, yan yung mga values ng CM for different cases. Sides with side sway or without side sway, with transverse load at saka without transverse loads. Okay, so let's have this sample problem number 2. It is a brace frame using moment amplification factors. So, as you can see from the member shown in the figure, it is brace against side sway. Bakit natin nasabi na brace against side sway? Kasi naka-hinge, di ba? Naka-hinge yung both ends. So, ibig sabihin, magro-rotate lang yung member natin, di ba? Magbabuckle lang siyang ganyan, pero hindi gagalaw or hindi magta-translate yung mga joints sa taas at saka sa baba. Okay, bending is about the major axis daw. So, major axis bending daw yung na-experience ng member natin. Check the adequacy of W14/90 A572 grade 60 based on the given loads. Okay, the loads are 40% service live load and 60% service dead load. Okay, so as you can see from the figure, the member is 4 meters in length and it carries 1,200 kilonewton service load. Tapos meron tayong end moments. Sa taas, may clockwise na 160. Sa baba naman, may counterclockwise na 150. Okay, then the properties of the W section used were given in the table shown. Okay, so first question, are you convinced that this problem fall under beam column? Beam column ba siya? Yes, diba? Kasi beam column, kasi because of the axial compressive force, column siya, and due to end moments, beam siya. Kaya combination siya na axial compression tsaka bending. So that's beam column. Again, pagka beam column, dapat ang analysis natin would start from the identification whether it is a smaller axial ba siya or larger axial. Diba? Doon magsisimula yung analysis natin. Okay. So what I did first is I solved for the ultimate load. So that would be 1.2 of the dead load. Ito yung axial, no? Axial. Plus 1.6 of the live load. And as what is given in the problem, 60% daw kasi is live load, dead load, plus 40% lang daw yung live load. So I got 1,632 kilonewton to be the ultimate axial compressive load or force. Then how about for the moments? Okay, yung moment na 150, I think sa taas yun, sa baba pala, no? Okay, so yung MU1 is yung nasa baba. Okay, that is the smaller end moment, yung 150. So I make it a factored moment lang. So by multiplying between 1.2 and the 1.6, so I got 204. Likewise, yung top end moment, which is the 160, I calculated also for the ultimate factored moment. So we got 217.6. Okay, so these are the end moments. Okay, so end moments. So ginawa ko siyang MU1. MU1 is the smaller, MU2 is the larger end moment. Okay, again, the first step that we have to check is to check whether it is a smaller axial or larger axial. How? By checking the PU over VPN compared with the 20% or the 0.2. Okay, yung PU, 1632 na, yun na yun. No? So, ang hanapin na lang natin is yung denominator, which is the design compressive strength or the VPN. V is 0.9. Ano yung PN? PN is FCR AG. And how do we solve for FCR? Ayun, FCR is based from the largest slenderness ratio, KL over R. Okay? Then, compare it with the C sub C. So, as you can see, it is intermediate column kasi yung SR natin is less than C sub C. For intermediate column, ano yung FCR natin? So, that would be 0.658 FY over FE times FY. F is the Euler stress formula, pi square E over KL over R square. So, substituting the values of FE in the FCR equation, we got FCR to be 353. Then, multiplying FCR with AG, we got the nominal compressive strength of 637. Then, substituting the values in the PU over VPN equation, we found out that it's 0.3 and that is greater than 0.2. So that means the beam column is more of larger axial. Again, pagka larger axial, malaki yung axial compression, maliit lang yung moment component niya. Maliit yung component ng moment component, that means we will be using the 8 over 9 equation. 8 over 9 equation. So ito yung 8 over 9 equation, if you could still remember, di ba? So we just have to check the adequacy by solving the value of the interaction equation if it is less than or equal to 1. Okay, so again, yung MYX natin, yung MUY over phi MNY would be equal to 0 because as per given in the problem, the applied end moments on the beam member or on the beam column are on major or x-axis lang. So walang binigay na load or moment load na acting on the y-axis. So, therefore, it's equal to 0 lang. Okay, so yung MUX naman, yung larger, no? Yung larger dun sa MU1 tsaka MU2. Kasi yung MUX is the maximum moment, eh. Okay, but since we will be adopting or using the amplification factor method, so the MUX would be calculated by this one, the B1 X MNT plus B2 MLT. Okay, yung B2 would be equal to 0 kasi the given beam doesn't experience side sway. Diba? As what I've said kanina, yung B1 is applicable for no translation. Yung B2 is applicable for with lateral translation. So for this case, wala tayong side sway. Kaya B2 would just be equal to 0. So ano yung B1? Okay, yung B1, yung MNT, yung moment with no translation is yung maximum moment dun sa beam column member, which is the larger between the end moments, yung 204 versus the 217. So, yung 217 ang mas malaki. So, yun yung MNT natin. Okay, ano yung B1X? That is, diba, CM divided by 1 minus PU over PE as given in the formula. And we have to check that the B1X should be always greater than or equal to 1. Okay, so yung CM natin, this fall under case 2. Bakit case 2 yung CM? Walang side sway, tapos may end moments. Ayun. Walang side sway, tapos may end moment siya. So, case 2 siya magfo-fall. Pagka sa case 2, ang CM can be calculated by the given formula of 0.6 minus 0.4 M1 over M2. Okay, ano yung M1? Yung M1 yung smaller end moment, which is 204, diba? Tapos yung M2, yun yung mas malaking end moments, which is the 217. Tapos if you will notice, ano yung direction ng end moments natin dun sa member, diba? Opposing sila. Yung nasa baba is counterclockwise, yung nasa taas is clockwise. They have opposing direction of end moments. So dapat, opposing means ini-negative natin yung M1 over M2 ratio. Ayun, so we have CM is equal to 0.6 minus 0.4 tas negative yung M1 over M2. Again, M negative is for single curvature. That means opposing kasi yung direction na end moments. So from there, we calculated si M to be 0.972. So yun na yung CM value, 0.972. So ibalik natin yung CM dun sa pagkuha ng B1. Okay? Again, yung PU, yun yung ultimate factored load. No? Tapos yung PE, yung Euler's load. So pag sinubstitute natin lahat yung CM, yung PU, tsaka yung PE, dun sa formula ng B1, okay, so ito yung makukuha natin by substituting all the values. So yung B1 natin lumabas is 1.007. And that is greater than 1, so that is acceptable. So although napakaliit, no, 0.007 lang yung yung amplified na moment, no? Lalaki siya lang ng konti, ng around 0.7% lang. So napakaliit. Pero at least this is how we consider amplification factor. Okay, so nagkataon lang from this example, maliit lang yung nai-amplify ng moment natin due to the P small delta effect. Okay, so thus, the MUX becomes the B1 multiplied by the ultimate moment. Yung ultimate moment natin, yung maximum moment natin na 217.6. So, yun na. So ano naman yung VMN? Yun yung design strength ng flexural, no? So you just have to look at the sample problem number 6 in our previous video. And from that video, we identify the design strength of that particular section. And if you will look back, we got MN to be 943.342, okay, from that previous lecture. Then substituting, for the CB, we need the CB, no? The CB would be given by this 12.5 M max, diba? Yung 2.5 M max plus 3 MA plus 4 MB plus 3 MC. Okay, so for our case, diba, ito yung beam column natin, hinge siya sa taas tsaka sa baba. Tapos yung load natin dito, diba, is yung moment. No, yung end moment sa taas, 217. Tapos yung end moment natin sa baba is 204. Okay, so we just solve for the reactions, yung 3.4, na-solve natin siya by summation of moments. Okay, say mag-summation moment ka sa ilalim, makukuha mo yung 3.4 dun sa taas. Then summation forces horizontal, makukuha mo yung 3.4 dun sa baba. Okay, so paano pa pagkuha ng CB? Maalala nyo ba pagkuha ng CB? Diba yan yung i-divide natin yung span into quarters, no? Na kung saan yung moment dito, ito yung MA. Tapos yung moment dito, yung MB. Tapos ito rin yung, So yan yung MB, tapos ito yung MC. Tapos kung sino yung maximum moment within the span of the member, yun yung Mmax naman. Okay, so by doing certain statics or cutting sections, cut and isolate, then do your statics, you could find out that the MA is 207. Okay, yung MB would be 210 and yung MC is 214 and yung Mmax is nandun sa dulo. I mean, nandun sa pinakataas, yung 217.6. Mmax is the maximum moment within the span kasi. Okay, so substituting this MA, MB, MC, Mmax dun sa CB equation, ang CB lumabas natin is 1.026. Ayan, so pag alam mo na yung CB, we just substitute everything in the equation. So yung first term of the interaction equation was done dun sa phi divided by PUX divided by phi PN. So yun yung 0.3. Yun yung doon natin nalaman na diba, larger axial siya. Tapos plus 8 over 10. This is the MUX. Ito yung maximum moment, which is the 219. Okay, dito yung nanggaling, no, yung 219. So, yun yung 217, minultiply natin ng B1, kaya naging 219. So, yun yun. Tapos yung 0.9, tapos 967. Okay, yung 967.53, ito ngayon yung MN. Okay, due to that, of the previous problem. Okay, kasi yung MN na to, I think kasi yung sinolve nating MN na to na 943 is based from a different CB. I think CB is assumed for this problem, number 6, No? So, again, yung 943 kasi, ito yung MN dun sa sample problem number 6 natin na kung saan in-assume natin yung CB equals to 1. Okay, so dito, ni-revise natin yung value ng MN by solving the actual value of CB. Okay? Again, sinolve natin yung bagong MN based from the actual value of CB. Ang lumabas doon, ang bagong MN natin is 967. Okay, so yun. Then solving for the value of the interaction equation, we got 0.524, which is less than 1. So therefore, the chosen section or the section used in the problem is safe. Although 0.5, medyo malayo pa sa 1 yan, so we could actually improve the section by choosing lighter section and check and verify if the interaction equation value would be less than 1. Okay, so this is how we analyze beam columns using amplification factor. Okay, so I hope you have learned out of this simple